Welcome, welcome, welcome. Everybody is welcome here. If you're Seminole, you're welcome. If you're Bakra, you're welcome. Everybody's welcome, and God bless your soul. My name is Bertha Faye Benson. My parents' name was George Faye. In Spanish, his name was Simon Alvarez. And my mother's name was Viola Mariscal. And they from Mexico. And they were Seminole Indian descendants. My daddy was born in Mexico. And my mother was born in Marathon, Texas. And my family been come from Mexico, Nacimiento, Coahuila, Mexico. A small town, small little village outside the town of Musquis, Coahuila, Mexico. Every summer, my family been go to Nacimiento, the little ranch at the foot of the hills. My grandmama keep the ranch up. It been have cattle them, it been had goat them, and pigs, and chicken, and we had goat them. In the afternoons when we've been there, we've been always calm, quiet, and in the evening, my daddy and my brothers would pack up the truck and get their hot them and then gone in the truck. We no knows where they went. And then when they come back, them had the truck full of cane, full of corn. We call it Rosania. And my daddy would fix the fire and fix up the sticks, start the fire and roast the corn, roast the Rosania. And I've been like it so much. I've been sit right by my daddy's side and I watch and I help and now that I'm grown, I know how to cook good corn. I know how to roast the corn real, real, real good. Other times, my daddy been bring the truck full of cane, long stick them the cane. And we peel them and we peel them. We cut the lip because it's sharp, sharp. You have to be careful. And we peel and peel them. We learn how. After we cut up our lip, after we cut up our fingers, then we learn how to peel them careful, how to peel them, how to chew it, eat them, chew it, and spit it out. Sometimes they been kill a bull, a calf. And all the people that live around the villages, they come visit. There were so many, I never even know that they've been lived there. They come, and where they come from? Where they live? I never knew there were so many villagers. And they come, they help, they cut, they dry them to make dry meat. Mm-hmm. And my daddy even get the bull them and lay them out over there and kill the bull. And after they've been finished, the other bull them, the big old Brahma bull with the big hump on the back, they come, they smell around there. And I don't know why, but then they start to fight. They come back, they back up, and they run into each other. I was a little bitty girl. And I remember I was so scared, but I had to see. I was up against the fence, just to watch. And I remember real, really good. My daddy been come to the kitchen door, and they been yell at me, get away from the fence. The bull gonna come and crush you. Well, I didn't know. My daddy been say, so I back up a little bit, back up. The minute I back up, big Brahma bull come rolling, hit the fence where I was. Woo, Lordy. But I was okay. I was good. Here I am. In Mexico, in the little village, we nobody had a washing machine, and no. My mama and my auntie, my aunt Alice, And I pack up all the clothes and lay the sheet out on the ground and put all the clothes. Seven children my mama had. And it folded up, tied up, put the big old thing up in the truck. And we go on to the Indian Creek. And that's where my mama been washed the clothes in the Indian Creek. My mama been make the fire for the clothes that she boiled. She boiled the clothes, the white ones, and she been scrub it on the scrubbing board in the water. And my mama been rinsing the water and hung up the clothes. And been hang the clothes up in the tree, up on the fence. And me and my brother, we've been the little ones of the family. And we play all day in the water, waiting for the water to get warm, but it never get warm. That water was cold. Spring water. And when we bring a watermelon, the watermelon was hot because the sun been hot. So we get the watermelon, put them in the water, because the water been cold. And the water, make the watermelon cold. We wait a while. For me and my brother, it was too long while. But wait a while, and then we cut the watermelon, it was good and cool.